just time. Ready.
And Hirata used to finishing opponents in the first round or in the second. She's never been to the third in her professional career. Nyrene Crowley, what an opportunity for the Kiwi. These days based out of Bali here in Indonesia. Cannot afford to give an arm or offer her neck to Hirata, because Hirata will take it home as a souvenir back to Japan.
Crowley's immediately starting to throw those kicks, and Hirata says she's looking to time those kicks, catch her, and that's how she's going to put her on the ground.
Crowley is a Muay Thai and kickboxing champion, decorated in both sports.
Crowley's just got some serious speed behind her shots.
Can she derail the hype train of Itsuki Hirata here? Hirata looking to go on the inside, put hands on Crowley, get a takedown. Crowley says taste a bit of leather.
Yeah, that taste of leather came from that right hand. Beautifully done, right through the guard, cut through her guard like a hot knife through butter.
Jab to overhand right there from Crowley. She's opened up like a house on fire, the Kiwi. Nice jab again from Crowley. And after the head rock back from the right, goes the outside leg kick. Snappy right hand, now puts hands on Crowley. The high knee! The Muay Thai clinch and knee from Crowley.
Beautiful knee inside that clinch.
What a start here from Nyrene Crowley, seizing the opportunity. And Hirata wants to get her down, wants to negate the striking.
You can see Hirata's trying to get inside that clinch. She's trying to close that distance. I'd like to see her shoot for the legs. Start punching into her takedown and then shoot in, trying for a double or possibly a single, because she's allowing Crowley to get off.
Crowley moving well in the early get-go. 2 minutes down, first round set for 3x5. The Kiwi counters, goes for a jab, body shot. Hirata tried to clinch up with her, couldn't lock on though. Crowley peppers out a double lead. Hirata can't match her for the boxing. Has some decent kicks on her though, the Japanese warrior. Jab there from Crowley. A nice knee hit from the Kiwi. There's the right hand, smack bang on the kisser. Shoots in for a double, because it's Hirata. Takedown. Crowley takes the back. Crowley riding her. But she might slip off here.
She's high on the back of Hirata. Let's see if Hirata can shake her off, but Crowley does a great job of adjusting, settling down into the hips, and now she's got that back. But she's on the ground with Hirata. Doesn't matter how she got there, she did choose to get there. But a beautiful defense so far from Crowley.
Crowley does have a rear naked choke over Anita. Carolyn at One Warrior Series back in July 2018. They're back to their feet now. This was a spellbinding contest. All tied up, another takedown.
That's that judo inside that clinch. She's in that headlock position. Let's see if she can separate those arms. She might be looking for a possible smart full position to a key lock. But a big branch!
Oh, the reversal! And side control now for the New Zealander. How do you do, Nyrene Crowley? House on fire, first round. And she allows her out to run.
Wow, she had side control and she wanted none of the ground game of Hirata and popped her back up. I like the strategy.
I'm sure her sister Dakota Kai will be jumping up and down at the moment, wherever she's watching this one there. WWE star, front kick there from Hirata. What a performance from Nyrene Crowley in the opening round here. Good right hand backs off the Japanese.
Talk about Crowley living up to the moment, taking this opportunity with both hands. Specifically that right hand.
Both women have had 5 pro contests. Hirata 5-0, Crowley 3-2. A chance to derail the Hirata train tonight. It's been the Hirata Express. 18-year-old from Japan has finished all opponents 100% finishing rate, all submission. Top position again for Hirata.
Oh, that was a beautiful build. I got her, she threw the right hand, left the right hand on the shoulder to get the clinch, and now she's in the take. Now she's on top, and now, look how she's overhooking that arm. She's wise to that bump of Crowley. She's able to maintain her hips and settle into the position.
This is Hirataville. This is Hirata land, and Crowley could be in trouble now. This is where it's good. Hirata is in such control. Half guard position.
Well, good job by Crowley to change the hips to recover half guard.
Final second. I see some battle in a tremendous opening chance here. Little one to the back of the head, though, Hirata. Couple of clean strikes to the back of the head. Hirata bleeds with the end of the round. And the first half of it, maybe even more, belongs to Nyrene Crowley.
Crowley was able to ignite this Jakarta crowd when she landed this beautifully timed knee. The clinch was where Hirata was most dangerous in that takedown. Crowley had it figured out, was able to lock in that clinch and throw those knees, but then Hirata does what she does best. She grabs your head and throws you to the ground. Beautiful job, but then Crowley with a beautiful reversal to end up in side control. Wisely chooses to get back up. What a back and forth round for the first 5 minutes as Hirata tries to energize this Indonesian crowd.
Ready. Hirata, second round of three. What a start though from Nyrene Crowley of New Zealand. And she keeps it standing and lines up Hirata again. With her hands, double jab, outside flanking. Hirata wants to put Crowley on her back.
Like that leg kick thrown by Crowley, you can see she's just a little bit ahead of Hirata in every one of the striking exchanges. She's got beautiful movement. She sees things coming and can slow them down, but this is where she does not want to be.
Hit recording the road show. There's another judo takedown. Third point of the match from Hirata.
So dangerous inside that clinch. She's able to use overhooks and underhooks, and she's able to put you down. So effective. Crowley might be able to pop her head out. She might get reversed at this position.
Crowley remaining composed.
It might be a kimura.
Crowley crossing market line in the corner of Nyrene Crowley. Amethyst strikes here from Hirata. Hammers away. Crowley, no place to go. Right in front of her, commentary position.
Yeah, there's that kimura. So she's got the legs triangled. She's got a triangle right there, and then she's hung for that kimura on the opposite side. This is a bad place to be as Hirata looks for that double trouble submission.
Nyrene Crowley all tied up like a pretzel with a long time to go in the second round.
I know Ariel Sexton is barking instructions right now at the TV as Hirata's trying to crank on this kimura.
Trying to move, trying to open up something, get free from there. Clinch, lock up her, Hirata. Submission attempt from Itsuki Hirata. Don't forget, folks, she has finished all opponents, all five by submission, all inside of two rounds. No one's ever taken her into the third. Crowley survived here, and they're the first to do so.
You can see Hirata's got a, kind of an inverted triangle right here, but it's not really that deep. She's not risking choking because Crowley's doing a good job of defending, especially with that arm. But she is going to be able to kind of do this, adjust her positions with this triangle. It gives her very good control over the body of Crowley. But she's got to adjust that a little bit lower. It's going to be hard to finish from this position, but a triangle is there. If she can find the right position, she might be able to apply the choke. But this is what it's able to do. It's able to allow her to move Crowley around and adjust the position and look for a second submission.
Hirata in control. Top position drives the elbow to the body of Nyrene Crowley.
Now she's going to go for a kimura. She sees she has that arm. She's going to try to separate the grip and look for it. Oh, she chooses to let it go and sprawl heavily. Look at Crowley working her way back up to her feet.
High knee there from Hirata. Doubles up with her. Here she goes in triple. Crowley through the ropes. Referee Kim Chin slaps the Kiwi's hands away. Crowley. Hirata. Crowley turns back into it. Hirata puts her against the ropes. What a tremendous second round. Another judo style takedown. That's four from Hirata. High control for the Japanese.
Michaels threw her on her face and then managed to turn her over to her back. Hirata does that beautifully. Very similar to Ayaka Muta, how she's constantly going. But Hirata's got a few more weapons in her submission game. So she's trying to find ways. Crowley's wise to what she's trying to do. She knows that she wants to take that arm, shove it underneath her leg, and look for a scarf hold position. But Crowley's keeping that body lock nice and tight. But that body lock opens her up to punches to the face.
Trying to stop those punches, clearing around the gloves, the forehead, the ears, the eye. From Hirata, staying busy, hips cutting. Side control, face open here on Crowley, taking punishment. Clean right hands between the eyes.
Hirata's got a good strategy here. You can see that when, you know, Crowley locks up the arms to prevent the scarf hold, that's when Hirata starts to punch. But then, when Crowley protects the face, that's when she's able to lock up the scarf hold position. Might be able to get a key lock here or an arm bar.
18 seconds away from Hirata being taken into the third round for the first time ever. It'll be deep water. It'll be unfamiliar territory. She's hoping for a referee stoppage here. Crowley surviving, referee catching on top of the action. He knows there's only seconds remaining. Crowley does survive. We go to the third. Hirata's never been there. Hirata's dancing. Playing to the crowd. And Xavier's got a semi-arm.
Hirata is feeling herself, and with very good reason. She was able to get this match, especially in those final 2 minutes, exactly where she wanted, and that was on top, looking for submissions. She was finally able to get that scarf hold position, was threatening with an arm bar, but Crowley's got pretty good dexterity in her arms, and she was able to survive. As Hirata plays again to the crowd, it's going to be imperative that Crowley keeps these last 5 minutes on the feet and does what she does best. She needs to shut down the confidence and the swagger that's oozing out of Hirata right now and put knuckles to face.
I'll tell you what, between Hirata and Rodzang and Stan Fairtex and Alma Unicorn, one championship has finally become Dancing with the Stars. Final round, Hirata full of confidence, dominant second stanza from the Japanese. Crowley's going to keep it standing, fire the heavy artillery now. See the damage around the eyes of the Kiwi. And she will not wave the white flag and go into the 90 at Nyrene Crowley. Let's see if she can unload those hands.
You can see some of those ground exchanges kind of fatigued Crowley a little bit, and a lot of shots are starting to get through that are thrown by Hirata. Hirata might want to take advantage of this situation and really start to apply some pressure. Here comes a takedown.
And a takedown. Fifth of the match so far for Itsuki Hirata. Passes easily. Both side control. So many options available. Crowley could be in a world of bother now.
The arm collector is looking for something. You can see her vision for that underhook. She flattens Crowley out.
And Hirata maintain her 100% finishing rate all by submission. The 20-year-old 5-0 coming in.
Nomura, look at her. She's going for it. She's trying to lock up that arm. Crowley's doing a good job of defending her. She's able to slide that arm through. Crowley needs to keep her hands connected.
As your time remains for Hirata. Put the kick away here. Crowley escapes. Nice knee there from Hirata. First jump on the left arm. Back to her feet, Crowley. Hirata continues to throw the knees. Trip takedown. Sixth takedown for contact.
Beautiful trip takedown, especially with the front headlock. That's going to add a lot of pressure to the neck of Crowley. Now Hirata's in full mount. This is a bad spot. Crowley's got to be careful not to extend her arms.
Out of my division, Stan Fairtex, Mai Yamaguchi, Rika Ishiga, Gian Rodzawan, all keeping an eye on this young lady. It's Hirata, and of course the champion, the unbeaten, the unstoppable, the great Angela Lee. To be a phenom, it's Hirata, and we can see why. She weathered the early storm and the stand up from Crowley in the open ground, and has been dominant ever since. Goes to side control, cuts the hit in here. Crowley back on one knee. Oh, can she see the choke?
submission defense, able to defend all of the possible attempts by Hirata. Hirata might have to posture up, look for a more dominant position, and rain punches down and get a TKO victory if she wants to stop Crowley. Because Crowley's tough.
This is such a brave effort from Crowley to take Hirata, a place she has never been before, into the fifth and final round. Rika Ishige, Angela Sabanel, Isabel Ferrunce, Neil Tamura, Colton Park, all could not do it. I could not stop this woman, and neither could Crowley. She is 6-0 now, and she has finished all six. You're watching something special. You're watching someone amazing. She is magnificent. She is Itsuki Hirata.
Look at those heavy hips. No space for Crowley to go anywhere. The punches just kept coming, and Kemp Chang was forced to jump in and give Itsuki Hirata her sixth straight victory. The undefeated streak continues, Michael Schiavello.
Itsuki Hirata, you've got to be a fan. At 20 years old, the talent level is phenomenal. What a show. Let's go to Tom.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 27 seconds in the third and final round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Itsuki Hirata!
What an ovation here in Jakarta for Itsuki Hirata. If you're wearing a hat, take it off to Nyrene Crowley. A tremendous performance from the New Zealander. And the winner's medal goes back to Tokyo, around the neck of this 20-year-old judo stylist who is absolutely cleaning up the opposition.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.